Now, more than ever, we need to shape up and look forward. In this video, I will share some of the tech trends I think will become a huge opportunity once all of this corona outbreak goes away. Hi. In the recent outbreak of corona, there is a huge wave of uncertainty and fear from the future. A lot of the businesses have to rapidly change or face closing down. Many people are at home in isolation and can't do anything about it. At these times, I try to look at the short and long-term opportunities and find hope and excitement in new things. For many people, this is also a good opportunity to learn new stuff and utilize the time to get into new domains. Today, I would like to highlight a few things that are already happening and will definitely have a strong impact this year and moreover next year. 5G. All major players are already pushing out 5G mobile phones and infrastructure. It will take some time, but 5G is definitely coming our way. You may think this means just more speed for our mobile communication, but 5G will probably have much more significant impact on our daily life, and probably sooner than we expect. The thing is, mobile communication has a real lagged experience due to latency, and for most of our use cases, it's fine. We do video chat, email, and play games. But anything that requires remote, real-time action is far from achievable without an extreme upgrade in our network capabilities. This is where 5G steps in. 5G will probably be used by IoT devices to transfer massive amount of information to AI-based data centers, enabling real-time assessment and then reaction. 5G will also empower real-time AR application for things like medical operations, autonomous cars, and so forth. AR, VR, XR. One of the biggest impacts for 5G may be on the XR, VR, AR space. XR is an umbrella term to all computer-generated realities. It can be AR, which is augmented reality, or putting virtual objects into real-life environment. It can be VR, which is a complete virtual reality that displaces us into an alternate immersive reality. And there are also nuances for that, like mixed reality, where virtual objects interact with real objects, and so forth. All of these technologies are busy with supplying us with some kind of extension to our existing reality. These technologies actually exist for decades and widely used in spaces like gaming and amusement parks. But the fact is that they have not really caught up in the consumer and business world. Every year we think it's going to happen and we are hit by the reality of technical barriers. However, some signs are showing that we may be getting there. For example, Apple is rumored to release their first AR headset pretty soon. It'll probably not be this year. However, the mere fact that Apple will be releasing a consumer AR product may tell us that the technology is getting ready to become commercially available for application developers. The devices coming from Google, Apple, Facebook, together with 5G, may finally enable us to really utilize these rather old ideas. One thing is for sure, we will all look rather stupid wearing them. AI and machine learning. AI is really not new anymore. It is widely used by many developers, and in many cases, what is referred to as AI is just a buzzword for data-driven computing. There is nothing really intelligent about training a computer to identify a picture of a cat. A 3 years old can easily do that. Heck, my cat can even do that. The concept of AI is constantly evolving and pushing its definition further. What was once measured by the ability of a computer to win a chess game is now considered a commodity of strong computing most of us hold in their hands. In the coming years, we're going to see a lot of implementation of these computing beasts as they become available as commodities from Amazon or IBM. Things like natural language processing or voice-to-speech recognitions are now made easy and can be used without understanding of the underlying technologies. But we have a long way to go and many challenges. Some of the biggest challenges are around autonomous driving. We're still probably quite far away from seeing a driverless car going around in our streets. However, we already see a lot of the foundation technology being integrated into our cars. There is no current standard for anything yet. There's a lot of opportunities for small companies to become players in this growing market. Decentralization. One of the most important ideas talked about in the last decade is decentralization. In the last decade, decentralized ideas are at the heart of many technological breakthroughs. Blockchain and cryptography introduced a complete new set of financial paradigms and ignited the imagination of many innovators around the world. Cryptocurrency has its ups and downs and will probably still be speculative for a while. but having Facebook into the game with Libra will probably make this seem boiled. However, use cases for decentralization do not stop with Bitcoins. There are many possible implementations, and we just started scratching the surface. For example, cloud storage. Decentralization is becoming a big thing in cloud storage. Think about all the privacy issues around the storage of a DNA assembly and how this can be used in decentralized ledger. Then there's more. Think about decentralization of software and design. Software has already been decentralized by applications like Git, and design is starting to do so with the idea of platforms like Figma that enables sharing design across many designers. 2020 will definitely have more room for decentralized ideas. Quantum computing. In October 2019, Google declared quantum computing supremacy breakthrough. For many, this idea does not mean yet anything. Like 5G, quantum computing will mainly mean speed. However, if 5G may be said to be 100 times faster than 4G, quantum computing can solve a math problem in minutes, where a regular computer will need 400 years. This means that we will be able to solve things we would not be able to solve in any other way. How would that impact us? Well, for start, it will probably not in the near future. In the long run, this will have profound impact on computers' capabilities in fields like AI, machine learning, cryptography, and more. This will give power for bigger bodies like governments and the commercial leviathans like Google and IBM. They will be able to solve really complex problems like genetics, encryptions, video processing, and the also relevant smart medical drugs to fight new scary viruses. I really hope that quantum computing will also be available for the wide community of developers and innovators, and will enable us to solve problems for the better good of humanity. I would love to hear your opinion about these new technologies and how they will impact us. Meanwhile, subscribe to our channel and get more product, UX, and innovation ideas. I'll be here next week, so keep safe and be healthy. Bye-bye.